Hello, I'm Karen Xu, the Product Application Engineer of the Add-on series. I will show you the Add-on MQTT function in the following video. We have the three topics in this video. I will talk about the operation in Add-on APAX utility, and where you could download this utility to operate with Add-on modules. And then here have two examples. First, I will use MQTT box to demonstrate the add-on MQTT publish and subscribe function. The reason I choose the third-party software MQTT box is that it is software with a user-friendly interface and is free to operate the MQTT function. At last, I will introduce how add-on modules connect to Azure with the connection string. And here, Azure provides the Azure IoT Explorer for users. With the Azure IoT Explorer, we could monitor the publish and subscribe function between add-on modules and Azure. First, you could download the add-on APAX utility from Advantech official website. In the utility MQTT interface, select the add-on MQTT enable and enter the host broker IP. Here, we provide the cloud brokers for users. You could also use the local broker and enter the PC IP here. Under the configuration, here is the publish topic and subscribe topic for your module. The topic index starts from 1, which equals to the module channel 0. You could select the topic you need to publish on this page. Each channel has 3 topics, including type, configuration, value. Next, we will demonstrate the different topics displayed in MQTT. Let's start with the first example. I will use add-on 6060 with the third-party software MQTT box to demonstrate how to publish and subscribe to the I/O data. By choosing the cloud broker IP, the port of MQTT is port 1883. If you choose the TLS, then the port should be 8883. And you could enter your broker username and password with TLS enabling. Here we do the basic demonstration without TLS enabling. After setting, click Apply, then wait for the MQTT setting done. Then move to the MQTT box. You could create the new MQTT client and enter the random MQTT client name. For example, here we use add-on 6060. And enter the host IP name, same as the MQTT host set in utility. Here we use the test mosquito org 1883. Remember to choose the protocol as MQTT TCP. After finishing the setting of reconnect period, keep a live setting and others. Click the Save button. You could see the connection with the green button on the top, which shows the successfully connected. If you didn't see the publisher and subscriber window, you could click and add here. Then, by checking the utility publish topic, we could choose the topic we want to subscribe in MQTT box, then copy it. For example, here I choose the DO1 value and pass the topic to the MQTT box subscribe. We could open the other utility and check the DO change. We could see when DO1 changes the status, the MQTT box subscriber will show the change in DO value. Now, about the publish function, choose the subscribe topic. Here, I choose the DO4 value and pass the topic into the MQTT dashboard. In the payload, please enter V true. And we could open the other utility to check the DO4 status change. Enter the V false. The DO4 change the logic low again. Let's back to the utility topic. Each DO channel has three topics. The first is about the DO type. The second will show the DO value as the demonstration. And the third will show the DO configuration. For example, the figure shows the pulse output setting in DO3. About the meaning of each abbreviation, you could check the menu on the Advantech website. Next, we will demonstrate how to connect Adam module with Azure. Be aware that Azure couldn't be applied when you have enabled the MQTT function. So remember to disable the Adam MQTT function first. In the utility, there is the IoT Hub connection string. You need to pass the connection string from Azure IoT Hub to here. Now, open the Azure IoT Hub you built and choose the device on the left of the page. Create the device ID. Here, I use the MAC number as an example. And the other setting, we keep the default setting. Click Save. Then you could find the device name you just created. Select the device, and here we will see the several key and connection string on the dashboard. Copy the primary connection string and pass the string to the IoT Hub connection string on the utility Azure page. Remember to click the Apply button after finishing the setting. Now we need to download the Azure IoT Explorer to check the publish and subscribe message. You could download it on the Microsoft official website. There is a link connected to the GitHub resources. I have already downloaded it, so I will open the Azure IoT Explorer directly. In the Azure IoT Explorer, before you add the connection, you need to copy your IoT Hub primary connection string. You could find the string under the Share Access Policies page. By clicking your policy name, you will find the primary connection string. Let's back to the IoT Explorer. Pass the connection string on it, and you could connect to the Azure IoT Hub you just created. Then I choose the Adam 6060 that I just created on the telemetry page. After clicking the start, you could subscribe to the DIO status on Azure IoT Explorer. We could open the utility to do the test. When I enable the DO3, you could see the DIO message including the DO change in Azure IoT Explorer. how could we publish on Azure IoT Explorer? Change to the direct methods page and enter the method name CTL-DO6 and the payload V1 to trigger the DO5. We could use the utility to check the DO5 change. The above is the demonstration of MQTT in the Add-on series. Thank you for your watching and see you next time.